This tutorial is part of our Django Database ORM Mastery course, where we learn how to master building and interacting with databases within a Django project. You can watch the entire course uninterrupted, ad-free, and access updated tutorial source code and other course resources from our Udemy course. Alternatively, you can access the course YouTube playlist featuring tutorials from this course. Links to our Udemy course and YouTube playlist can be found in the video description. This and the preceding tutorials in this course section aim to introduce Django ORM core components. It's not intended to be a deep dive into the subject matter. We hope to introduce and take the first steps, priming you with the knowledge for further exploration in the course. Having said that, in this tutorial, we're going to learn Django models and fields, that they are in fact the most fundamental feature a Django developer must understand to create Django applications that can define, create, manage, and interact with a database. So this tutorial starts our journey towards mastering models and fields by exploring the underpinning concepts. What is a Django model and field? Once we have that initial understanding of Django models and fields, we will also better understand the relationship between Django models and our project database, tables and fields. For those who would like to watch, I will walk you through the stages of constructing a database in a Django project at the end of this tutorial. The intention is to help you visualize what we have learned so far, rather than it to be a step-by-step tutorial that you can follow along and replicate. In the previous tutorial, we defined ORM as a design or architectural pattern. The Django ORM integrates features of this design pattern, which defines how we implement database tables and fields and manage them throughout the lifecycle of our application. So before we discuss tables, database tables, and fields in the context of a Django ORM or Django project, in case you are new to databases, let's first define a database, table, and fields, and general database terms. So the first essential component of building a database is database software. Database software, more commonly known as a relational database management system, will provide the tools to build and manage our database. So popular relational database management systems include MySQL and PostgreSQL. There are many more. However, MySQL and PostgreSQL are generally the top of any popularity list. Within our relational database management system software, we construct or build databases. Now, relational database management systems can manage multiple databases. Typically, in a Django project, we just have the one database. So I like to think of a database as a container where we logically organize tables and establish relationships. Our project may have 5, 10, or more tables. Tables store data logically in rows and fields. So here we have a representation of a table here. So this is our table. Our table name is called student. Inside of this table, you can see that our table will have one or more fields. So here we have some fields, columns, or attribute names at the top here, and that represents a new field where we are going to logically store representational data related to the column or field name. So generally, in a table, we need to define a field name, the type of data that will be stored in the field, and then any other constraints that might validate the data before being inserted or updated, so that we can ensure that only specific types and formats of data are stored in each of these fields in our table. Data is inserted into the database as a new row or record. Each field is populated with data in our row, which adheres to the field specification and constraints. Of course, we will learn much more about different field specifications and constraints in this course. But just take a look at this example here. Let's imagine we have this field student name. We wouldn't expect to see any numbers in this field or stored in this field here. So we may set up a constraint which will prevent the user from typing in any numbers into this field. And by doing that, we are trying to make sure that the data inserted into our database is clean and consistent throughout our table. So there are generally two approaches to traditionally inserting or creating tables and fields in our database. First, we may use a third-party software to connect to our relational database management system and use that interface of the software to create database tables and fields. We might alternatively use the terminal or command line to connect to our relational database system and then send commands via the terminal to perform operations to build and manage our database and tables. And this approach might require SQL. As we have already determined, the Django ORM provides a NoSQL approach to managing our database. Now, strictly speaking, although I mentioned that the Django ORM provides a NoSQL approach, behind the scenes, Django ORM will be converting our Python code into SQL. We will discuss that in more detail in a later tutorial. So let's talk about the Django approach. Well, the Django ORM implements concepts from the active record design or architectural pattern. An active record pattern defines an approach for accessing data in a database. A database table is wrapped into a class. We generally describe this class in a Django application as the Django model. Now, this Django model that we will be building, this new class, the Django model is initially needed to build a database table and then interact with the corresponding database table. As we will see in this course, the Django models will be the definitive source of information about the database's tables and table fields. Anytime the application needs to interact with the project database, we need to refer to our models. So there's quite a bit of information there already, and like I said at the start of this tutorial, I will give you a visual preview of creating a Django model and just take you through that process so you can visually see us actually building a Django class, a Django model, and then I'll take you through the migration process and we can see the actual database table being created. So let's summarize what we've learned so far. The Django model, in actual fact, is a class. Now, if you're not familiar with object-oriented programming, it'd be well worth potentially doing a little bit of reading and understanding some of the basics there, although you still will be able to follow this course. Now, this class that we build, this Django model, will contain the fields and any behaviors related to storing and retrieving data from our database. So we've actually learned that there is a relationship between the database table and the Django model. Once we've created the Django model, we then migrate and map it to the database table. So the database table will initially get created from the Django model. From then on, we need to maintain our model and ensure that our model is up to date and reflects the database table at all times. So because of that, we say that the Django model is the definitive source of information about our database tables. So now I'm going to give you a demonstration of building a Django model and then migrating that to a database that is attached to our Django application or Django project here to give you a visualization of what we've learned so far. Please remember, this is not a step-by-step tutorial. You can download the code for this example in the tutorial resources. But like I said, this is not a step-by-step tutorial. Let me just show you how to build a model and just take you through the different theory that we've covered so far. So I've gone ahead and created a new Django project, called it test project. And this is where the settings or the main Django settings are found. And then I've created a Django app, a new Django app. And inside of that app, by default, Django will provide a models file. So typically that is where we're going to actually create our Django models. So ultimately we are going to be building a database table. At least we're going to be describing a database table here, which is then going to be made into a database table. So we're going to need tools to do that. And you can see here from Django DB, we import models, which is going to provide the tools to actually be able to describe a new table or new Django model and the fields that are stored or the fields that make up that particular table. So remember we mentioned that our model is a class. So we're going to create a new class. So we give that class a name. Let's make a student table. And then we need to bring in the tools that Django provides. So models.model. So in order for us to build a or define a new model and fields within our table. Now I'm using different terminology here because ultimately this here is a description of our database table and fields. I think you maybe already get that already, so I won't say that again. So here we're going to have some fields. So let's define, for example, the first name of a student. That's what we want to store. Remember, fields are basically ways of us defining what we want to store within our table. So here we're going to say model. Now we need to define the type of data. I did mention this previously. So we need to define the type of data that can be stored within this field. So in this case, it's a character field. We'll learn more about that in this course. We need to define some other parameters here. For example, this max length. So this is going to define the maximum amount of characters that can be stored within this particular field. I'm just going to set it at 100 for no particular reason. Let me just zoom out a little bit so we can see all the code. So to summarize, we have a new class called student. That's going to be the name of our new table in our database. We then have a new field within this table, student, called first name. And we define what type of data can be stored in this field. And then also then some other constraints. In this case, we've created a constraint that prevents anyone from typing in more than 100 characters and saving it within this field. Right, so by default, Django uses an SQLite database, which is a file-based database. So it simply is a file that will appear here. We don't need any additional software or tools. That is just something that we can utilize as a database for our project until maybe we're ready to migrate our project to another type of relational database management system. So if you're wondering about the database, that's all handled by default utilizing an SQLite database. Right, so once we finish creating our new model here, we now need to actually build this table in our database. So to do that in Django, we can type in or use the management command here and then make migration. So what we're doing here is we're building some instructions for Django to initiate. So I'm just going to run that and you can see that a new file has been created in our app here where our models reside. So inside of our migrations, there's a file here. So this file is the code that Django needs in order to actually then convert into SQL, structured query language, so it can provide the instructions to the database to actually build our table we've just described. So now we have that in place, we just move this up. We can now run and tell Django to commit this or to actually run this initial migration. So manage.py and then migrate. So we're actually now going to build our table. So as soon as we build our table, you can see here that we have a new database, a new SQLite database. Now, by default, Django has a whole bunch of other applications that are installed. If we go into the main test project folder here, you can see inside the settings here that there are a number of different apps that are installed by default, as well as the app that I created. Now, what that means is that Django is going to search through all of these apps and have a look to see if there is any requirements for any database tables. If it does find any, it will create those too. So that happens just to be the case here. So let's go in and actually have a look at our database. Now, by default here in Visual Studio Code, we can't do that with an SQLite database. But if we go over to the extensions and install SQLite? Yep. If we install SQLite here, this is an extension which will enable us to inspect our database. So go ahead and install that, and then we can then have a look at our database. Now, you can download this, like I said, at the start of this little tutorial. So you can actually inspect this if you like, if you install the extension. So right click, open the database. It will appear at the bottom here, bottom left hand corner, and you can now see this is our database here. So I can right click, well, actually I can drop it down, and I can now see all the tables that are inside of my database, one of them being the student. Now, what Django does here, you can see that it uses the name of the app underscore, then the name of the class, the model that we created, to actually name the table in the database. You can also see that we have the first name, which we described, as well as this ID field. Now, this ID field was automatically generated by Django. That's the primary key for this table. That will be another topic of discussion throughout the course. So notice that it also describes the type of data that this field is storing, and in addition to that, the maximum amount of characters that can be stored in the field. So what we can now do is right-click and show the table. So we can actually see the table now. If I just move this across, we can actually see the table. Now, we don't have any data in the table. So I've gone ahead and created some data. Let me just refresh. So I need to right-click and show the table again. And you can now see our table in the database. It has one row, two fields, ID and first name. Remember, these are field names at the top here. The first value here in this field is 1. That represents the primary key. And then we have the first name field, which represents the first name of the student. And we see the name. So we can now visualize and see the relationship between the Django model that we've created and the actual table in the database. So what's going to be important here throughout the lifespan or life cycle of your application is that you keep the model up to date and it reflects the actual table in the database. If you were to remove some of this data and then not update the table to reflect those changes, then you would have errors or cause errors in your application. And like I alluded to also, the fact that this model here will be utilized every single time we manage our table or do something or work with our table here in the database, because it has all the information that's needed by Django in order to determine, for example, what SQL statements to create, because it knows, for example, this is the student table. It also knows what type of data that we're trying to insert into the database. So it was able to convert the data, the type of data, into a compatible type, so it can then be stored in the database, and vice versa. What we have now here is a data type that's going to be slightly different from the one we're using here in Python. So potentially, the Django ORM needs to convert this back when it returns this data into our Django application into a data type that can be used by our programming language and the Django application. So the Django ORM is going to manage all of that for us, and it can do that because we provided all of the information here in our Django model. Like I said, you can download this code in the tutorial description. Have a go at installing the extension here, SQLite extension, and then just have a look, see if you can right click on the database. It should be available, and see if you can inspect the database.